Subscribe to Niger's Craziest. Press the bell icon and never miss another video update.
Hello guys, welcome to this episode. Civil war is breaking out. You know, civil war on where to bury our father in the Lord, Prophet TB Joshua. It's a fight between his village people and his family. The village people said they don't want their son to be buried in Lagos. For all of you that are not in Nigeria, Lagos is a state. His village is in Ondo. It's another state, Arigidi in Ondo. So the king of Arigidi came out to say that they won't take it lightly with TB Joshua's wife. If the wife goes to bury TB Joshua in Lagos, that TB Joshua has done a lot for his village. And the village, they value him. They want their son's body to come back. Watch the king, and when you come back, we'll talk.
But my trouble is that his wife and the children should not allow them to bury him in Lagos. We are not going to take it lightly. He's from this town, and we want him back here. That's the only trouble I have now. Yes, I've not had access to the wife, and I know I'm going to talk to her. Yes, she's not from here. That's another trouble now. So she can decide anything she wants, but we are not going to take it lightly. We are not going to take that from anybody. We have to, you know, everything that happened in this life, leave it to God. God is in control. He gives and he takes. He's the one that gave him to us, and he has taken him. And then my belief is that he has finished the job he come. Yes, that's my belief. With his interview or his speech, 2 days ago, you will know he knew already that he's ready to go. So, who will query God? Can anybody query God? So we have to accept whatever will happen. Since 1 o'clock a.m. yesterday till now, I've not slept. In fact, I have to cut short my interview, because when I talk, I'll be crying again. Nobody, he has time, I've finished the job he come for. That's the truth of the matter.
This thing is two ways. I agree with the king in a way, because TB Joshua is a man of tradition and he came from somewhere. Is not a Lagosian, so it will not make a lot of sense in their own eyes to bury him in Lagos, because he needs to be brought back to his fatherland, which is Arigidi. The king is making it very clear that the people of Arigidi want their son to be brought back, and it's basically tradition. It's tradition. While I agree, I will ask, if TB Joshua was a nobody, like nobody knew TB Joshua, will they be fighting for him to be buried in Arigidi? Plus, TB Joshua has probably done more for his village than his village has done for him. TB Joshua is a man of affluence. Now that he's dead, everybody wants a piece of the action. The question now is, if TB Joshua was a nobody, like say Joshua, nobody knows Joshua, this thing happened, would they be fighting for him to be buried in the land? They will even say, we don't have space in Ondo for him. The village cemetery is full. Bury him in Lagos. This is what we are saying. If you are a nobody, nobody cares. You know, that's why they say, hustle low, so that you can make money, so that they can drag where they can bury your dead body. Now, let me talk on behalf of the wife. The wife is not from Arigidi in Ondo. She probably wants to bury her husband where his legacy lies, you understand? She probably wants to bury him in the church. And TB Joshua is not an ordinary man again. He's not an ordinary man. The people of the church too, we want TB Joshua to be buried at the synagogue. Have you been to synagogue? Mass expanse of land. And the founder of synagogue, it only makes logical sense that the founder of synagogue should be buried inside that compound. It makes a whole lot of sense for TB Joshua to be buried inside the synagogue. The members of synagogue, they would love it to be able to go to their papa's grave. Some of them have not even agreed that TB Joshua is dead. If TB Joshua is buried in the synagogue, people can still go and see his grave and say, oh, this is the grave of TB Joshua. Maybe they can get healing from there. But if he's buried in Ondo, it won't make sense like that. So that is speaking on behalf of the church and the family. Now let's speak on behalf of TB Joshua himself. What if TB Joshua left a will to say that he wants to be buried in the church? Have you people thought about it? The king of Arigidi, have you thought about it? What if TB Joshua wrote in his will that said, I want to be buried in the church? Or he has told his wife that when I die, bury me in my church. Have you thought about it? So you need to open a line of communication between you and the family so that you know if TB Joshua left a will or if he left a request before he died where he should be buried. Not fight, because fight will not solve this one. It's not just wake up and start fight. Mm-mm. Respect the dead man's wish. If the dead man wants to be buried in his church, Biko, allow his family bury him in the church. It's as simple as ABC. There is no fight in this one. There is no fight. Let the dead man wish be granted. That is my own. And let his followers be able to see where they buried their pastor. Thank you guys for watching this episode. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram at LaughMayor. You can still follow Aboki on Instagram at John Joshua Comedian and follow us on our social media handles at Nigerian Craziest. Don't forget, you can become a patron of Nigerian Craziest from as $1 as much as $1,000. Don't forget, you can become a member of Nigerian Craziest now. The join button is beside the subscribe button. Just click the join button, select the package. Don't forget, we have a backup channel, it's called My African Truths. Please go there, subscribe. Don't forget, our merchandise is on Teespring. Please go there, buy. All the links are in the description of this video. And don't forget, for all of you saying that way, you should let dead man lie. We are mainly bringing you news. What did we do? I don't know why people just get in their feelings. We did not say. Somebody said, and we analyzed what the person said, and you are accusing us. I don't understand people. Somebody said, you have 200,000 subscribers. You can be using your channel for something creative. So what we are doing now, saving lives, is not creative. It's not creative enough for you. Oh yeah, Auntie Bibi, tell us what can be creative for this channel. Tell us, since you know and you have a channel that has over 200,000 subscribers and you have experience, tell us. Let us know what will be creative. Thank you guys for watching this episode. Don't forget, question everything, because normal is boring. See you.